I wonder. Got some more glowstones.
Good day.
Hello, blacksmith. A zip trolley. Yes, we want that. Thank you very much. Now I can make use of those zip lines. Anything new here?
Did you pick up a paper?
I will do. How much?
It's free. We're supported by donations from the community.
Yeah. Interesting. Yes, I'd like
Sure thing. Would you like to donate a glowstone to the Shadian Post so we can keep the paper free, without ads and unmotivated by pop news and tabloid journalism?
Sure.
Thank you for your contribution.
I don't mind paying a little to support a good business. So, right, so this is what I needed to be doing. Let's put it here. Moon's shadow. Okay, and just clicking that. It gets rid of it. Good to know. So, the advertisement is up. We have... what is the time? It's time to get back to the... get back to the Tarnished Teapot. See if there's a different performance on. Then we can read the latest newspaper. So that's where my painting went. Let's see how many I can get up onto that ridge. Quite well. Ooh. That's quite a few.
Gather round. Come hear tale of trickery and wit. There was once a witch who lived in a tiny
house. That's still doing the same performance.
She was skilled in the healing arts and could cure nearly any ailment.
And this looks like the new Shadian Post.
Though she had many visitors,
issue Now, here we go. Shady and Patch, proven innocent. Potion seller proves his strongest potions are illegal. Reported by Esther Clearbell. Kai and Kaelin Riverside are the owners and potion developers of a once bustling apothecary near the Fellstream River. The apothecary fell into infamy as Kai was long suspected of using illegally sourced and nationally protected ingredients in the potions. Though never formally charged, suspicions ran deep enough to stunt their business entirely. In fact, this report discovered that few citizens had ever even heard of the apothecary. However, in recent events, the allegedly illegal potions were tested and confirmed to contain no trace of protected ingredients. While it's unclear how the rumours began, the couple is ecstatic to have been proven innocent. The two have amassed an astonishing level of debt and are finally on track to begin paying back their kind supporters. But there we go.
Wasn't so treacherous, and she had gone in many times for lesser cures. So she agreed to find the heart.
All well that ends well.
Flara trudged through the swamp, thick with slime and the stinking air heavy with rot. When she came to a clearing of black clay, she threw
it's another one of my paintings.
But alas, nothing. She dug for hours, her back aching and fingernails packed with mud. Finally, just as twilight fell to darkness...
Is there anything else I could be doing right now? I don't think there is.
Glowing like a star. She lifted the root, heavy with swamp water, and slid it into her bag. Not a moment.
Still need to find more of the hot springs. Anyway.
Stolen from me. That root is not yours to take.
It is.
I had a
the witch could just make
short nap
of a moss elf
last night, so tonight we'll get some proper sleep in and catch up. And there we go. A new day and new opportunities. Get back to the balloon. And of course, I've also got the zip lines to check out.
Adventurous folks looking to take flight.
That's good to hear.
Say, you really saved my invention. Would you like to take a ride up to the mountaintop?
Yeah. Why not?
That's the spirit. Hop in, pal.
In. Or did you need to get in first? You needed to get in first. Okay. Oh, here we go. can't get out your easel in here. I guess it would be a bit cramped. Oh, but the potential for painting up here. That pop-in is a little bit severe. Still, from what I understand, this is a one-man development team. That over there. That's worth checking out, I think, if I can get up there. Gorgeous. I seem to have picked up speed. Oh yeah, looks like we'll be able to get up there. I bet you there's a hot springs up here as well. I did play this game a couple of years ago, but a lot of it I've forgotten. Ah, there we go. Oh, whoa, whoa. Golly, here we are. Even more spectacular than I always dreamed. Feel free to walk around taking the sights and... Yeah. What? Okay. How did I end up here? A little unusual. Thankfully it's let me back in. Oh, I was a little bit worried for a second there. What's this little fence really doing? Well, we do need to try and get back down before the eclipse begins, so I'm not going to be able to loiter for too long. I do want to get up there. But first, what's up this way? Ah! It is indeed another hot spring. Fantastic. And... equipment, empty vial. There we go. That is another vial of spring water. Now, to get up this set of steps. Obviously it's important enough for us to have these glowstone lights and rocky steps placed here. What is this? Oh. I wonder if that's useful for something later. sure we'll find it. If that is indeed the case. That's a shame that you didn't come along with us. You're cooped up in the basket all this time.
Are you ready to head back?
I am indeed. I could skip, but I think they'll be doing the game an injustice. I think in the future, though, the trips back and forth I'll skip, but you must experience the trip there and back properly at least once, I think. View. Words can't describe, really. I hope none of you have vertigo, because I'm sure that could have been quite stomach-churning. There we go. Out we get.
Thanks again for all your help. There's nothing so exciting as bringing people on a great adventure. Just let me know if you need another lift to the mountaintop, pal.
Thank you. I'm sure I'll be making use of that offer at some point in the future. Right, well, the eclipse is nearing, so I do have to try and get back to that strange... stone feature. Carved stone feature. In the Blushwood. Just outside the Blushwood, I guess. I guess we still got some time, but... when you're waiting for celestial bodies, it's best to be a little early so you've got some time to prep. At some point, I am going to have to try and make use of that mountain wort tea. And that way I'll have tasted the tea and maybe get an effect from it as well. I can't remember if there is one. So yes, that poem that was recited to us, I believe, refers to this. Specifically this view during the eclipse. So let's have a look. Mudwillow's riddle. Itself in a constant state of falling. To you it seems that it's always stalling. A stony sight when the star hides away. A watchful eye at the peak of midday. The day turns dark, but a moment in time. The star goes black, though everything's fine. The largest of eyes that stares back at you. A sight that aligns. That's the moment I choose. This appears to be the view. So we shall see. There's a nice tower over there. I wonder what's going on with that. It looks like there's someone walking about atop some scaffolding around it. I guess there's some construction work going on over there. Something we're going to have to work out. The secret too. Yeah, I'll paint over this, I think. Actually, no, maybe this one will be the one I get rid of. Yeah, I don't have the wood to craft another canvas, so it will have to be this one, unfortunately. Oh, the time approaches. So, I hope everyone's enjoying this little trip through the island of Eastshade. Well, I'm guessing this is the island of Eastshade, because it is an island. We've just been able to confirm that with the hot air balloon ride. But yeah, this has been a great experience so far. There's quite a bit to explore still as well. And we still have further paintings to paint for fulfilling our mother's wish. There's obviously going to be more besides. Still, I'm in no rush to leave this place. It really is quite beautiful. It looks like it's getting close to time, so I shall get the easel out and get to painting. I think this is the view we're after. Do I want more of the mountain or less of the mountain? I think with the angle we're at compared to the this carved stone feature. Don't quite know what to call it. We'll go with more of the mountain for this one. I think that looks good. And now the eclipse is starting. Oh yes, definitely getting there now. Actually, you know what? While we're waiting for it, let's go with the Bloomsack tea. And Okay. Now that's quite a nice view. Slightly subdued. Yes, that's the view we're after. Get a little bit taller. And we paint. My word. That is nice. If I do say so myself. That's that completed, so let's get back to Mud Willow and hand this painting in. So I do have to reposition these her mirrors once again. So I'll just put that one there. And this one round about here, I believe. We'll see in a little bit. All that's going on. Let's have a look. See if there's anything we can pick up around here. Yeah, there's a stick. Ah, there we go. There's the beam of light. I was slightly off. There we go, that should do the trick. And down we go again. Hello?
Ah, here is something unexpected. I thought my riddle went neglected. The glowing sun confines me to mud, but this, it puts life in my blood. It's yours, most valuable thing I own, a trade for the clever wit you've shown. This brew's the only one of its kind, and its powers need a solid mind. Drink slow, once a day, your eyes will grow clear. Just a sip, and treasures will glow when you're near. Sip up, see well, but exercise care. This sight drains your spirit, till none can you spare. I devote myself to studying eyes, and I've seen plenty brimming with lies, but perhaps you're different in the end. Best wishes to you, my clever friend.
Oh, thank you very much. Do I still have that painting? I do still have that painting.
Painter, back again. Use the tincture well, my friend.
What do you know of the night drummers?
Ah, it was you they saw in the dead of night. That makes sense. All is right. You see more than others do. That's all I'll say. Away with you.
Interesting. Not terribly useful, but interesting. Something about treasures. Wonder if that's got anything to do with the treasure that we've been sent to find in a cave. Ah, right. Should have been paying more attention to that. I can now come and go through there when I please.